Damn, this season is polarizing as shit. People either think it's the greatest thing since sliced bread, or they want everyone behind the scenes who wrote it to die. The part that kills me is it's all pollen shippers. It's all like, we are still a congealed family, but half of us are like, girl, this was garbage, and the other half is like, what are you talking about? I loved it. Like, there is no room in the middle, and which is where I find myself, because like I said in my previous video, I love the first three episodes of this back half. It's the final episode that chapped my ass, that really pissed me off, and I hated it. Hated it so much. And everything I hated about it had to do with a writing standpoint. Not that that's not what everybody else's complaints are about, but I particularly hate everything about that last episode because of the bad writing. Really quick, for the four of you who watch my videos and don't know, I went to film school and I majored in screenwriting and have a bachelor's in fine arts, and I double majored also with a minor in creative writing. And I used to work for NBC and Warner Brothers, you know, in a past life. So trust me when I say I sort of kind of know what I'm talking about when I talk about bad writing. I do have a background in it. I used to do I used to be a script reader. I used to be executive assistant. I was in creative development, which I really liked a lot, until I started working for this trash little production company. But that's a whole nother story and a whole nother life, child. But anyway, all that to say that, like, you know, please have a little faith in me when I discuss, like, you know, my issues with the writing of that last episode, the season finale. Okay, right off the bat, the thing I hated the most about that final episode, the thing I could not fucking stand, is that now everyone knows that Penelope is Lady with Whistledown. I hate that she outed herself. I hate that the entire town knows. I think that was a stupid move on the writer's part. And the thing that makes me hate it the fucking most, honest to God, is the, like, 2-minute time jump at the end. Because if you're gonna have Penelope come out as Lady Whistledown to write her gossip column about everyone in the ton, then I think the most logical thing to do next, and would be more interesting to see next season, would be how people react to her now. Like, she's no longer a wallflower. She is the Lady Whistledown, and everyone fucking knows it now. So I think it would be hella fucking interesting if we saw, like, her being out in society, and, like, you know, some people avoid her, some people try to get on her good side so she writes good things about them, some people are anxious and nervous around her because they're afraid of what she would write, like, some people try to bribe her into writing good things, like, that, and it, I think that would have been so fascinating and so interesting. And then you would have Penelope getting really fucking irritated about everyone knowing she's Whistledown and trying to curry favor with her, or scurrying away from her in the streets because they don't want to be read about themselves in her gossip column. And I think you could have gone one or two ways with it. The following season, in season 4, you could either have that remedied somehow and her still continuing Lady Whistledown, or maybe she starts a gossip column as a different person and she keeps it, like, under a different pseudonym, and she keeps insisting, like, that's not her, but it's actually really fucking her, and the only people who know are her and Colin, so they can share that secret together. Or you just have her quit being Lady Whistledown, a gossip columnist altogether, and then you have her taking on the job as editor. Like, she starts by editing the book Colin's writing, and the book becomes a success, and then, you know, he passes her name around to publishers to try and get her a job as an editor, and there's a lot of them who won't hire her because she's a fucking woman, and then you, like, find one that does and they hire her, and, like, that's how her season arc comes to an end. In season 4, she's an editor now with a publisher, and you make it, like, this really small, weak little, like, publishing company, but Penelope's so good at her job and she's so good at finding talented writers and writing their stuff that the writers for that little publishing company blow up, they get big, all because of her. Like, child, tell me that doesn't sound better than sis standing in the middle of the ugliest ball ever. And I get it, her sisters are tacky bitches with no taste, so yes, that ball was ugly, but standing in the center of it, confessing to everyone, and the queen giving her quote-unquote permission, and that's another motherfucking thing. I fucking hate that the queen knows that she is Lady Whistledown now. Because first off, what was the fucking point of that conversation between her and Lady Danbury when they were playing chess? Because I could have sworn what Lady Danbury was trying to get through to her was like, hey girl, you keep trying to unmask Whistledown, and that's really stupid because the truth of the matter is you like this chase. You like the little back and forth you and this anonymous bitch have with each other. And if you find out who she is, what now? What then? What do you want her to do now? You want her to start publishing only good things? Because that was your initial problem with her. She was calling you out for being wrong about shit. And then on top of that, like, the whole chase of this and the whole anonymity of it and you not knowing and being frustrated, all like, this is all occupying your time and helping to distract you from the mental deterioration of your husband who you love so much. Because that's what this all this is. Because, like, I couldn't understand for the longest time why sis gave a damn about some gossip columnist, even if she did say a few nasty words about her for 100 years ago, because the last time I remember her even saying anything saucy about the queen was in season one. But that's all this is for the queen. It's a nice distraction away from the thing that hurts her. And I really wish that was also an emphasis that they put on in this season. Because, like, to tell you the truth, since season two, I've just been like, why the fuck does she care? Like, I kind of, like, the writers lost the plot, and I kind of, I guess I'm lost through the trees in the forest about why Queen Charlotte cares so much about this bullshit. Like, it makes no goddamn sense to me. Like, and then season three, like, she's just aching to unmask her, and like, it just makes no goddamn sense to me. However, I think if the queen was to know that Penelope was Lady Whistledown, I think it would have been better if it was in private and it was like a little secret they shared. If Queen Charlotte figured it out and wanted Penelope to come to the palace, and told Penelope, you know, in like a little private meeting that, like, girl, I know it's you. Keep up the good work. or better yet, in Charlotte's case, like, telling her, girl, I know it's you. And I love a good enemy. So put your dukes up because I'm coming for you next season. And then Penelope goes, I wouldn't expect anything less. And I'll see you there. And they battle it out like that. And like, but having Penelope exposed to the whole ton and all that, like, I just hated it. It was bad writing. Because where the fuck do we go now? Especially after that time jump. No goddamn sense. Piss me off. Furthermore, I also fucking hate that Lady Danbury knew. Actually, no, I'm stating that wrong. I love that Lady Danbury figured out that Penelope was Lady Whistledown. I wish, though, it was more of a bigger reveal. That whole scene where they're all standing around in the Bridgerton morning room arguing over what to do about Cressida, who's blackmailing Penelope, and Colin's like, no, I'll fucking handle it, da-da-da-da. I would have loved for Lady Danbury to just walk into the room, expose the fact that she knows that Penelope is Lady Whistledown, and she goes, I will fucking handle this. And she does. And she handles it. Penelope still keeps her anonymity as Lady Whistledown, and the only people that know are the people in that room and Lady Danbury. Like, that would have been so much better. And that would have created a nice relationship between Penelope and Lady Danbury, who is just the boss bitch that Penelope wants to be. The only difference is Penelope, you know, wrote a column for her money and Lady Danbury married into it. I just think that that relationship could have been gone a lot better and a lot smoother. That's just, I just hated that.